Talk show host Rush Limbaugh, with zero proof, suggesting a Chinese bioweapon lab is to blame. A Chinese official tweeting, it might be U.S. Army who brought the epidemic to Wuhan. But to find the real source of this pandemic, it's best to leave it to science. CNN has spoken to a half dozen virus hunters who right now say anyone who claims they know the exact source of the novel coronavirus is guessing. Did it come from bats? Most likely. Chinese researchers have already determined the coronavirus is 96% identical at the whole genome level to a bat coronavirus. 27 public health scientists from across the U.S. and the world wrote this letter in the journal Lancet, condemning conspiracy theories and citing scientific evidence, including the U.S. Centers for Disease Control, that supports the theory that overwhelmingly conclude that this coronavirus originated in wildlife, as have so many other emerging pathogens.
The common thread is wildlife. These pathogens emerge from wildlife.
One of those scientists is one of the most preeminent virus hunters in the world, Peter Daszak.
Because we'd been doing this work in China for 10 years, we had a whole series of genetic sequences of viruses we've found with our colleagues. So when they got a new virus in people, the cause of COVID-19, they could compare it to what they'd seen in bats. So they knew straight away, this is likely a bat origin virus.
And because it has that 96% comparison rate to what was actually in a bat, that's why you're saying it's very, very likely this did come from a bat, although we don't know where this strain actually came from.
We're very confident that the origin of COVID-19 is in bats. We just don't know where exactly it originated. That's what we need to do now.
Oh, just a bat.
It is a genetic detective story. Researchers will trace the virus that is killing thousands to a yet-to-be-captured bat in the wild, to a potential animal that became the crossover vehicle for COVID-19. Yes, the virus could have transferred directly from bat to human, but most likely, says Daszak, it was bats infecting farmed animals, the animals brought to market alive and kept with people in one of the most perfect incubators for viral infection, the Chinese wet market.
This huge diversity of animals live in cages on top of each other with, you know, a pile of guts that have been pulled out of animal and thrown on the floor. As you walk towards the stalls, you slip on feces and blood. These are perfect places for viruses to spread. Not only that, people are working there, people are coming in and buying animals, they're chopping them up in front of you, kids are playing there, you know, families almost live there.
It's called zoonotic spillover. Professor Andrew Cunningham with the Zoological Society of London has studied them for decades.
Wet markets, these live animal markets, are certainly a very good way of, if you like, trying to get a virus to spill over into people from wildlife. They're susceptible to getting viruses or other pathogens from the environment or from other animals that they wouldn't naturally come into close contact with, again, because they're stressed. And then they can become virus factories, and they're in close contact with human beings in the markets, and they're butchered in the markets by people in relatively unhygienic conditions.
Other researchers point to reports from China that some of the earliest cases were not associated with the wet market. And then there's this theory, widely debunked, this paper from two Chinese researchers that says it is plausible that the virus leaked accidentally from one of two labs near the Wuhan seafood market. After an uproar and heated denials by the Chinese government, one of the authors told the Wall Street Journal the paper had been withdrawn because it was not supported by direct proofs. Experienced virus hunters Daszak and Cunningham say the theory is bunk.
People don't keep bats in captivity. Complete baloney.
We don't need to invoke conspiracy theories. It's just basic biology.
Tensions between the U.S. and China over the origins of the virus and accusations of misinformation from both sides are slowing the work of the virus hunters, who are grounded by the same travel restrictions that have crippled the world. That is concerning. Because without knowing where it came from, there is still a chance that original host species is spreading it.
If there was a so-called intermediate host, an animal that the bat virus got into and then allowed it to get into people, the virus might still be in that host. And there are hundreds, thousands of these animals in farms, and maybe the virus is still there. So even if we get rid of the outbreak, there's still a chance that virus could then reemerge, and we need to find that quickly.
Jake, the answer lies in China, and with Western scientists still unable to travel in yet, the trail on the hunt for this virus is just growing cold.